Today, let's talk about selecting the right probability model for your data. For a dataset, you may be considering a few different types of probability models or distributions. How do you know which one is the right one? Based on the great comments provided on this channel, I want to introduce you to Quantile plots, a powerful yet simple visual tool I frequently use to evaluate the fit of my probability models. In less than 10 minutes, I will step through with you the basis of this concept to compare any set of probability models. We will see how you can extend quantile plots to analyze real data, and I will show you in 3 minutes a Python example where I implement this concept to analyze a real dataset. So let's first talk about how you can visually compare any two probability distributions or models, and these next 2 minutes are really key for what follows next. In probability, we frequently see a bell-shaped curve like this one. We refer to this line as a probability density function, representing the relative likelihood of each possible outcome. The important item, but also the really confusing item to remember, is that these relative likelihoods are not actual probabilities. To compute a probability from these plots, we need to define a range of interest and determine the area under the curve for that range. If these concepts are new to you, then I'd encourage you to first watch a past video where I explain this concept in far greater detail, and a link to that video can be found in the description. Now, the area I just highlighted is a really important type of probability. It forms part of the cumulative distribution function, which represents the probability of a certain outcome or less. So, to determine the cumulative distribution for a given outcome, we can compute the area under the curve that is left of the outcome of interest. In this example, the cumulative distribution function grows to a half at around the outcome 70, as half the area under the probability density function is left of that value. And as we can see, as we move to the right, our cumulative distribution function increases up until a value of 1, as there is a 100% chance that we are less than or equal to infinity. Now, you may want to model this uncertainty with a different, narrower probability distribution, and we can of course map its probability density to a cumulative distribution function. These two distributions look pretty different in both graphs. I'm going to propose, though, that we compare their differences in terms of their cumulative distribution, which forms the basis of quantile plots. And I should probably note here that there are multiple variants to quantile plots, and so I'm really highlighting here my favorite version in this video for sake of brevity. To construct a quantile plot, let's select a value along the y-axis and map that out to a given outcome. This is referred to as a quantile function, which maps different cumulative distribution values to outcomes. I'll do this for this particular cumulative distribution value, and I'll proceed to do it for a few other values along the y-axis. And let's store these four results for both our blue and yellow distributions. And with that, we can now create our quantile plot, or basically a scatter plot, for our four observations. I'll make the yellow distribution on the y-axis and the blue one on the x-axis. And let's overlay a 45-degree line on top of this plot, and let's look back at our cumulative distribution function. And suppose that you were to take the yellow distribution and change it so that it was exactly the same as our blue one. What would happen then to our scatter plot on the left? Well, each of the four cumulative distribution values would now be associated with the same outcomes for both distributions, and therefore our scatter plot will now gravitate to our 45-degree line. And so the more similar these two distributions are to each other, the closer they will be to this 45-degree line. And with this simple visual, we can now quickly comment on whether two probability distributions or models are the same. So we now have a technique to compare two probability models. How can we use it to comment on whether our empirical data follows a proposed probability model that we fitted to the data? Here, I'm going to take this dataset, which in this case is composed of 500 observations, and I am going to sort them from smallest to largest. We can now compute what is known as the empirical cumulative distribution for each observation. Remember, the cumulative distribution is the cumulative probability of an outcome or less. So we will say the cumulative distribution value for the smallest value is 1 in 500, as 1 out of 500 observations are less than or equal to that value. The second is 2 in 500, and so on up until the largest value, which is equal to 1, as all the values are less than or equal to it. We can now draw our empirical cumulative distribution and overlay a proposed theoretical model. And we can now compare our empirical distribution with our theoretical model exactly the same as before. We simply plot the empirical quantiles for the dataset versus the theoretical ones. And given that our two distributions look very similar, unsurprisingly, our scatterplot lies on our 45-degree line. And of course, if I were to propose a model that deviates from our empirical data on the left, so too will our scatter plot on the right from our 45-degree line. And so I hope that you can see that quantile plots are a really great tool to comment on whether a proposed distribution matches well with your data. We simply look at whether the scatter plot that we generate lies on this nice, simple 45-degree line. So let's implement this process to analyze real data. We will use Python, and we will primarily rely on two libraries, SciPy and Matplotlib. I've provided a link in the description to the script created in this video, with commenting provided to clarify some of the details and arguments chosen. First, I'm going to import a CSV file through a library known as pandas. Let's print our data, and as noted earlier, we have 500 total observations. Our dataset that we want to estimate is sitting in the column value, so I am going to create a variable called values that references that column. Now I'm going to use SciPy to fit a few different distributions to our data. Let's try not only a normal distribution, but also a couple of others, say log normal and gamma. And that is it in terms of model fitting. Through SciPy, I have now proposed three probability distributions, and I have now stored each of the model fits. So now that we have three fitted probability distributions, let's compare their theoretical quantile values to the empirical data to see which one best matches our data. And I'll do so through Matplotlib. And let's first just do it for a single distribution, say our normal one, before doing the others. First, I will use the available function probplot in SciPy to generate my empirical and theoretical quantiles. I'll have to specify the empirical data being analyzed, the fitted distribution parameters, and the distribution type. I personally prefer to not use the automatically generated plots, so I have more control over my graphs, so I'll set that argument to none. Let's now initialize a plot. We'll create a scatter plot, where the theoretical quantile values are sitting in the array index 0, and the empirical quantile values in the array indexed 1. I'll then layer on top of this plot a 45-degree line, where the min and max for the values define the range it is shown for. And I personally like to color it red just to make it really clear and visible. Now let's quickly label our axes, add our legend, and show our plot. And ta-da! There we have a plot comparing our empirical data with the theoretical quantiles. This normal distribution did a pretty darn good job of matching the data, which, to be honest, I expected ahead of time, as I randomly generated these data from a normal distribution. Now, having said that, as we just discussed, you may be considering other distributions. To add them, I'll do it in just four simple steps. First, I'll create two more arrays where we are storing the empirical versus theoretical quantiles for the log normal and gamma distributions. Through subplots via Matplotlib, I'll make three plots, one for each distribution, and have them be directly next to each other. Now let's define each scatter plot, and note their empirical and theoretical quantiles. And once I've done that, I'm just going to write a quick for loop. For each subplot, I want to show both my 45-degree red line and legend title. And let's now show our plot, and there we have our plots for all three distributions. We can see that, particularly for the log normal distribution, the tail end of the distribution for the theoretical distribution is not aligning well with the empirical data. It is deviating from our 45-degree line, and it is also increasing in a non-linear sense, an indicator that it is probably not the right distribution to select for this data. And so through this video, you should now have a good sense of how to visually evaluate whether your data follows a defined probabilistic model. Namely, quantile plots are a really powerful visual check to ensure your data follows your proposed model. Now, I want to end this video with a sincere thank you to all of the previous comments received on this channel. Your support through subscribing and commenting on the types of things that you'd like to learn more about have had an immense positive impact. Thank you as always, and I look forward to seeing you soon.